Hey guys, thank you all for tuning in today to this BDSM movie review. Firstly, I want to say again, thank you, and I am happy to take you all on this journey with me. So a little background before I get into the movie review. I am very much interested in learning a lot about BDSM. And you all will be seeing that in the coming times. People that know me, know what's up. And thank you for supporting me. But outside of that, I will say that this movie that we are going to, we're going to touch on today, we're going to review today, it was the catalyst to my interest in BDSM. And I expressed my interest in BDSM to a mentor of mine, and she sent me a full list of movies that include BDSM. They're more like female dominated type of things. I am very grateful for that gift and opportunity, because I don't know. I feel like I've been sitting on this list for a while. I've been sitting on this list for maybe, I want to say about a year. Yeah, I've been sitting on this list for a year. I've been getting my life together. Life is finally coming together a little bit, so we can finally get into this. And I feel like I stated in. Like I stated in the little Instagram story that I posted up, I haven't been too much of a movie buff. And I was like, well, if I'm going to get into movies and watch this full list of movies, why not, one, make it fun, and maybe you all can chime in and watch them and tell me how you feel about these movies. And maybe we can like do something way more fun outside of just reviews with these movies. So, with all of that being said, again, like I said, thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to share this video if you know anyone that may be interested in BDSM or just into kinky stuff, sexual stuff, sensual things. Send this video to them. Maybe they will be interested, and hopefully they can follow your girl. Anyways, so without further ado, the name of the movie today that we will be reviewing is called Secretary. I put in the guess which video, which movie I'm going to be reviewing today, answers The Secretary, but it's actually called Secretary.
I've never had a job before, but I can assure you that I am very excited about this opportunity. Are you the lawyer?
So before I get into that, I want to read off, because guys, I don't memorize things very well. I'm going to be honest, especially like, yeah, I just don't memorize things very well. I'm going to be honest, because I don't got the time. Like, I got too much shit to worry about. I like to read things, and I don't mind, you know, reading this off my phone. So it's a movie dated back in 2002. It's supposedly a comedy. A romantic comedy slash drama. Now, it was, well, it had its funny moments, I would say, but to me, it wasn't a comedy. Like, it was so intriguing that it was never a comedy. Maybe the first time I watched it, it was so intriguing. And then the second time that I watched it, I would say it was kind of funny. I don't know. There were some giggles in there, right? So the description of the movie is, a young woman recently released from a mental hospital gets a job as a secretary to a demanding lawyer, where their employee relationship turns into a sexual sadomasochistic one. Love it. And I'm looking at IMDb, and they gave it a 7 out of 10. Like I said, I'm not a movie buff, so I don't really know too much about ratings, but I would say for me, I really, really love this movie. So let's say 7 out of 10, maybe, since because it was supposed to be a comedy, but it wasn't that key-keying for me, wasn't too funny. I would say, yeah, 7 out of 10 is very on point for that. So with that being said, Oh, before I get further into this, y'all, I'm a little slow, right? And I told y'all to pick the right movie. The movie I was originally going to do was on that list, and I accidentally made it the wrong answer. But Secretary found its way being the right answer. So with that, I guess it was fate, because like I said, this movie was like the first movie I've ever watched that had BDSM undertones or overtones, because it's very out there within the movie. And I think it might have just been fate, because it really pushed me into the direction that I'm going within my life now. So back to the movie. Yes, so let me get into the actors and actress. So the actress is Lee. Okay, so the girl's name in the movie is Lee Holloway, and she works for Mr. Gray. Mr. Gray is actually James Todd Spader, and Lee is Maggie Gyllenhaal. I believe I'm saying her last name correctly. Yes. And, oh my God, guys, their chemistry in this movie was amazing. Like, I loved it.
Are you shy? I'm shy.
I don't think you're shy.
Do you really want to be my secretary?
Yes, I do.
So, I don't know if I want to give spoilers or if I want to... I'm going to give like a quick rundown of the movie, right? So the movie starts off, like they said, she came from a mental hospital. And like, you get to see the inside life of what her family structure is like. Her parents are kind of kooky. I believe like one of her parents may be like on drugs. Like her mom like be popping pills or something. It was like her mom was like popping pills or something. Like she was just like out of it because the father, no, I think the father was a drunk and the mother was just trying to cope. So she was just like, you know, in abusive and toxic relationships, usually the mother will be like the enabler and then the father would be like the abusive person. So that's kind of what their dynamic was as far as mother, father. And then with Lee, which is the girl character, she pretty much was you could tell she had a lot of anxiety. She definitely dealt with a lot growing up, because she went to the mental hospital for cutting herself. And we would see like little undertones of, I think the movie starts off with her at a party. It was, I believe, a welcome home party, I believe. I don't know if it was a welcome home party, but it was a party. And nonetheless, like, her mom had seen her with the knife and was like, you know, be careful. So her mom was very, like, you know, wary, like, be careful, trying to keep her on the right path of recovery. Now, oh, girl, they're like that. You know, like, when your parents tell you something and you're like, mom, like, I already know. It was kind of like that for her. Like, she was like, I know I'm not going to do it again type of thing. So she eventually goes to take a typing test to become a secretary. She does the test and she passes. She passes on her first try. She's very excited. I believe she starts... So she starts looking for a job, and the job that she gets, eventually, I don't want to give too much of the story, but eventually she starts working for this lawyer. Now, when she goes there to work for him, I think, okay, so, like, as somebody that, like, likes to analyze relationships, this is why it really intrigued me, because it was like, okay, like, they got the psychology down so well, because, like, she was very, she came from a very, messed up background, and she had this anxiety about her. But what was also funny was that her lawyer boss had an anxiety about him too, and his anxiety was more so like he liked to control everything, and he liked to make sure that everything was in its place when it was, you know, in its place, and everything was done how it needed to be. And like, it starts off with her when she goes into the interview, she sees this lady running out and crying, and that was the old secretary that he was obviously firing. So, later on down the line, you know, he's very demanding, and she kind of likes, like, you can tell, like the undertones is kind of, like, very sexual and sensual. Like, you can tell that she likes, you know, bending over backwards and serving this man. So, there's also a woman, she's kind of like the hard ass, dominatrix, the working woman, the take no type of shit woman. And, she comes in there looking for him, and she comes screaming his name, and you can tell how submissive, like I said, he has this anxiety about him, but you can tell how submissive he is to her. Like, instantly, as soon as she calls him in, he runs over to her, or, like, he'll say that he's not there because he's afraid of her, right? He doesn't like to be controlled, so controlling women obviously instill a fear within him. And so the girl begins to lie for him whenever she would come in and things like that. So then there's this guy, Peter, that she's dating while she's not at work, and Peter likes her. Like, Peter is like, I didn't like Peter at all. Peter is like that creepy ass, Peter, sorry y'all, Raven. So Peter is like that guy that is, he's like really creepy. Like, ladies, you know that guy that, like, he wants to talk, like, he likes you. So, like, he's real creepy about it. But, like, you can tell he's like a goody two shoes, and you're just like, sir, you're being very creepy. You're not even being, like, it's so funny because, side note, I was thinking about this and I was like, dudes don't really know how to seduce women these days. Like, they're creepy. They don't know how to actually seduce. They're very creepy and weird, or they lie. So it was just one of those things where it's just like, sir, you're like being weird and I don't find you attractive. And honestly, you need to leave me alone. So it was one of those things, and he would like just be doing weird things. So he wanted to have sex with her, but she wasn't into him. Like, she's not into that. Like, honestly, even within this movie, I don't think they ever had actual intercourse. They never had actual intercourse. Everything was very much sub-dom, masochist, sadist type of thing. Yeah, they never really had sex. I would say around the end, they might have, you know, it could have alluded to them actually having real actual intercourse. But, like, during the movie, they never had sex. I don't even think she was very much into sex, because she would cut herself. She was just into the pain, and that's what turned her on. That's what made her feel good. So when this dude, Peter, when Peter wanted to have sex with her, she was like, Peter, I'm good. Like, she did it, but she did it because she felt like she had to, which I would say, women, don't ever feel like you have to fuck these niggas. Like, we'll talk about that another day, but, she did it because she felt like she had to. And, because she felt like she had to, it just wasn't good. So, but the thing is, this, boss of hers was always on her mind. Now, I am telling the story a little wonky because I'm just doing this off of memory. Like, I didn't rewatch the movie. I'm just giving you all bits and pieces. I've watched the movie probably like twice, maybe three times. So I'm giving you all bits and pieces of what I remember off the top of my dome. So, yeah, like, it was very weird, with her and Peter. And Peter, like, obviously, he really, really liked her, and he wanted to marry her. And he told her, like, I remember I did watch a preview. I watched the trailer to refresh my mind. And, in the trailer, he said something like, I want to get married and have kids. And you can tell she was so disgusted by that. She was just like, no. And I laughed, like, okay, the movie was kind of like a comedy. Like, it was funny because when he was being awkward and weird, it was funny as shit, because it's like, she don't like that. Like, sir, stop it. So then, after that happens, So the part where they actually realize that they're both into the same thing, I'm going to get to that. So there's a part in the movie where something happens and Lee gets so frustrated, cause she carries her cutting kit everywhere she goes. So something happens. I don't know if it's either her mom calls her and tells her something she doesn't like, or, Mr. Gray tells her that he doesn't like something that she did. I don't know, but she got really frustrated. After getting so frustrated, she runs to her desk, she takes out her kit, and she starts cutting herself, and Mr. Gray sees her. But when he sees that, he kind of gets turned on, and she sees him, and she packs everything up. So that's when he realizes, like, oh, she's, like, into some shit. So when he realized that, he was like, okay, let me kind of be a little nice to her. Because he was very mean. And he starts softening up to her and, you know, making her feel more comfortable. Pretty much, well, I don't want to call it grooming, but in a grooming way. But, like, if you know anything about a dom sub relationship, the dom a lot of the time plays this parental nurturing role. So that's what he was doing for her within her frustration. So he tries to calm her down and make her feel better, and that kind of ignites some intimacy between the two of them.
Why do you cut yourself, Lee?
I don't know.
Is it that sometimes the pain inside has to come to the surface, and when you see evidence of the pain inside, you finally know you are really here? Then when you watch the wound heal, it's comforting, isn't it?
That's a way to put it.
I'm going to tell you something, Lee. Are you ready to listen?
Yes.
Are you listening? You will never, ever cut yourself again. Do you understand? Have I made that perfectly clear? You're over that now. It's in the past.
Now, things start to get heated where, like, they would have sessions, like, in between clients and things like that. They would have sessions, or there would be a time where she'll, like, make a mistake in a typing assignment that he gives her. And, like, he'll call her in the office and he'll start spanking her and all of that, to the point that she starts to make these mistakes on purpose.
Go type up a bill for that woman for $500.
Aren't you going to proofread the letter?
But there was a time within the movie where Mr. Gray, he starts...